For a long time, people have worried that some evil hacker would take over the world's critical computers and cause a global outage that would put the damage on a scale of like that is so great it'd be called catastrophic. Well, the company CrowdStrike seemingly decided to not wait for an evil hacker to do it, and instead deployed a faulty component in their security software, which went ahead and caused that global outage for millions of people. Not everyone on the planet was affected, but a lot of people were affected. Also, they didn't decide to do this. It was an accident, but anyway, on July 19th, millions of Microsoft users, well, Microsoft Windows started to get hit by the infamous blue screen of death, and frustrated IT departments began getting endless amounts of calls for systems being down. And it wasn't too long before we started to see that this was a big problem, but also no one was expecting it to be as big of an impact as it truly was. A lot of people are affected by this, to say the least. Even people who are not actually using Windows and using this particular type of software, the CrowdStrike Falcon software specifically, there are people who are affected by this who aren't using that because it affected businesses that, you know, you were trying to just buy something and you couldn't buy it because this whole thing happened. And it gets a lot worse. But a lot of people are misplacing the blame onto Microsoft because it is only affecting Windows machines. But to be clear, this is not Microsoft's fault in this particular instance. Unless you count how poorly an operating system it is to seemingly require something like this to even exist in the first place. But that's a different topic for a different video. This was not caused by Microsoft directly, but rather the company CrowdStrike. So tons of people were scrambling to figure out what was happening because this buggy update broke millions of machines, basically impacting millions and millions of people through outages for hospitals, airlines, emergency services, payment processors, stock exchanges, TV networks, and the list just continues on and on. So many other types of businesses were affected by this, causing what would be accurately labeled as, well, just chaos. The CEO of CrowdStrike went on to CNBC to apologize for the issue and provide some explanations. He said that this was not a cyber attack, and that's good, and it was not a code update, that's also good, but rather a faulty content update. Not good. Content in this case refers to things that the tools are looking for to identify malware and bad actors and that sort of stuff. The solution to fix this issue ranges from, well, simple stuff like rebooting the systems, although up to 15 times back-to-back is necessary in some cases. And in those some cases, that wouldn't work enough because there's also, it goes all the way to requiring IT departments to send someone to physically fix each machine manually by removing the offending file that was uploaded. Due to the complexity of the issue, the massive impact it caused, some companies have been able to get back up and running, but there are still many, many companies in many industries struggling to get back to normal operations. The CrowdStrike outage did not affect Linux users or Mac users, just Windows users. Now, CrowdStrike is available on Linux and macOS, but the faulty content was specific to Windows machines, which is why only Windows machines were impacted by this bug. Why are we wondering, does this mean that Linux is better? Well, yes. Okay, I guess not exactly, since it wasn't Windows' fault in this case directly, but yes, Linux is certainly better in many ways. But again, that's a different topic for a different day. I have seen some people downplaying the impact of this issue, which is shocking to see. I mean, sure, it was isolated to one planet and Mars wasn't impacted, but other than that, it was a massive problem. I think it's good that CrowdStrike quickly acknowledged the problem and didn't try to pass the buck. So at least that's good. But how did this happen? You would think that they would have a large test environment for testing things like this before they deploy them, you know, to the world. And in theory, this would have been found if they did. Now, I would assume a company with an annual revenue of $3 billion like CrowdStrike could afford to have such a testing environment, you know, large enough to catch stuff like this kind of thing. Maybe having like hundreds of computers that to deploy the updates to make sure each update is stable enough prior to deploying it to each customer, which effectively would impact the rest of the world. Because apparently they have over 24,000 or had over 24,000 customers. and which then means there's a lot of machines that are impacted by each customer, theoretically. However, I'm also aware that it's not typical to have these kinds of things. It's not the typical way of doing things in the tech world. So I'm not surprised if they don't have a testing structure like that. I don't know if they do or not, but I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't. In hindsight, there were probably many things that CrowdStrike could have done better to prevent this. But, you know, as they say, accidents happen. You know, that reminds me of another saying. It's known as Hanlon's or Hanlon's razor. And Hanlon's razor is an old adage that states, never attribute to malice that which is adequately explained by stupidity. I'm not calling them stupid. It's just, it just reminded me of the adage. And I just wanted to tell you about it because it's kind of a funny adage, though they probably do feel a bit stupid right now. So what will happen? This is a question that everyone is asking. I'm guessing there will be probably investigations by various countries. CrowdStrike's stock price already plummeted quite a bit, and there will very likely be many lawsuits from the damages it caused, which some reports are saying billions or even trillions of dollars in damage, but who knows? It will be fascinating to see how the dominoes fall for this one. But to everyone who is, you know, affected by this outage, I hope all is well for you. And if it isn't, I hope it gets resolved as soon as possible. And to everyone at CrowdStrike, well, I guess just good luck with things. If you enjoyed getting news like this, well, this is not necessarily Linux news, but it is definitely technology news. You might want to check out the podcast that I do, which is called This Week in Linux. It is a video podcast here on this channel, so be sure to subscribe and you can get up to date with all the stuff that's happening in the world of Linux and sometimes tech if it is big enough to be this kind of thing. So be sure to subscribe. This Week in Linux, the best podcast on the planet that I host by myself related to news and making it weekly. A lot of qualifiers there.